Hello, racing fans, and a warm welcome to Trackside, proudly brought to you by World Sports Betting. Bet with the best, bet with WSB, a leader in the fixed odds betting market and number one in the anti-post betting market. Okay, guys, I trust that everyone's well, keeping safe, and having an awesome week punting winners around the country. And there's lots to look forward to this weekend. It's a double header. Of course, we race on Saturday at Greyville, where it is the World Sports Betting Race Day, and the main event is the World Sports Betting 1900 meters, where we see the return of a dual Durban July winner in Do It Again, and he is the overwhelming favorite on the World Sports Betting menu. The last price I saw was 17-10, and he takes on a field where there is some form to go about, but if he's anywhere near ready, I'm sure many of you out there expecting him to win and win well. That's on Saturday, and then on Sunday we move over to Turfantine. What's happening on Trackside? Well, we've got our four horses to follow for the weekend. Two trebles will be up on the World Sports Betting menu, and I've given a straight line place accumulator for Saturday. It's the World Sports Betting Race Day at Greyville, so we're going to go with a straight line place accumulator, and that will come up after we've chatted about our four to follow. So where we go with our four to follow, guys, and our day will begin in race number two. It's an early start on Saturday, and this is a WSB Bet with the Best maiden juvenile plate for fillies. It's over 1400 meters. And the runner that we're looking at is the Mike de Kock train, number three, Ready to Fly, daughter of Give Me the Green Light. There was some money for her on debut, and I kept a very close eye on her. That was on the 27th of April, where she raced at Turfantine. It was the inside track over 1,200 meters. Tricky course to make your debut, and she was drawn 7 out of 9. Richard Faree, yeah, he did not hustle or bustle this filly to try and get an early position from that wide draw. She was green for most of the way, but when she started to put her mind on the job, she caught the eye. She was running on second behind Captain Peg, and from that form line, on Thursday at the Val, we saw, I think it was in race number one, Roy Magnus filly called United Express come through to win with Gavin Larina. So that form has held up pretty well. She's nicely drawn at three, having her first run at Greyville. That is a big bonus. And when you look at her pedigree, well, she is a half-sister to On Top of the World, winning races from 1900 up to 2000 meters. So whilst she'll enjoy the step up in distance, I think she's the type of filly that's actually going to be better once they put her over further. And you just have to have a look at the way Mike de Kock's going to be placing his horses here in KZN. He's obviously come down with a string of horses that he thinks will be competitive. And when it comes to the young horses, he must have a plan with this filly. There are feature races to come over 1,200, 1,400 and 1,600 meters during the KZN Champions season. And the fact that this filly is down, the daughter of Give Me the Green Light, I think the stable may have a plan for her, and this is where it could all begin. She wins nicely over 1400 meters, and then they may be thinking about where to aim her in the feature races. And on a pedigree, I think the 1600 meter race on the last day of the season, which is the Tequini Stakes for fillies, that could possibly be our main aim, this filly. But I'm hoping that this 1400 meter trip, with natural improvement from one run to the next, she will be a hard filly to beat, because Richard Faree got a good feel for her last time out. She's nicely drawn this time around, hopefully not too green around the turn, and when they turn into the straight, all she needs to do is find the finish she showed last time out at the Turfantine inside track, and I think that she will be the horse to beat. Number three, Ready to Fly in race number two. Then we move along to our second horse to follow, and I mentioned that we got four horses. Well, three of them come up at Greyville on Saturday, and the second of our three horses will be in a maiden plate, World Sports Betting Best Prices First 1600 meters. And this maiden plate, well, I've been waiting for this fellow. His name is In the Summertime. He's a son of Noble Tune. And of course, whatever form guide you're using, just look under the ownership and you'll see it is Bayer Racing Club. And of course, I'm the nominee of the Bayer Racing Club. And this individual's had two good runs to date. He would needed his introduction that was over 1600 meters, and it was a fair run. And then next time out, jockey Anton Marcus partnered him again at the course over 1600 meters, and he was just left alone from that poor draw, draw 9 out of 9. And when they turn into the straight, well, Red Soul skipped and looked very hard to beat. But of the rest, he was the horse that was finishing off his race very well. And when you pull out his pedigree, this horse, very interesting. He's related to, you know, Exeter was a 6-time winner. Entree was a 6-time winner. And of course, Eventual Angel, a 5-time winner. So the siblings have done very well. Anything from 1300 up to 2000 meters will suit them fine. And it's no surprise that Garrett, put him out on debut over 1600 meters. And whilst he is going to appreciate a bit further, I'm just hoping that he can get away with it over the 1600 meter trip with jockey Anton Marcus up. The word from the stable that is that he's very, very well. I've seen his gallops as well. And he is progressing nicely back home. He takes on a field where there is some form to go about. But Garrett Finzel is positive of a bold performance from him, and he's invited all the syndicate members, those who can make it to the course, to possibly lead in a winner on the day. So a stable's confident, and we're hoping that in the summertime can put his act together at his third start and hopefully give the guys a good win here. So number 5 in the summertime in race number 5 on Saturday. And then we go on to race number 6, and it's She's a Keeper. Well, she needs little introduction, this mare. She's a 5-year-old now, the daughter of Gimme the Green Light, and she's been on the boil this season. Trainer Garrett Finzel hasn't been shy to travel her. He's had her for the Cape summer season, where she's run in the Cape Merchants, in the Paddock Stakes, in the Mallorca Stakes, and she hasn't been disgraced in all of those runs, of course taking on a star in Captain's Ransom. And then last time out, it was Her Serene Highness Princess Charlene Empress Club Stakes when they traveled to Turfantine. So she's been on the road as well. And when you look at that run, you know, draw 12 out of 13, I think Anton had no option but just to drop her out and hopefully see her run on. And she made steady progress through the field. She was certainly not disgraced behind Princess Keller and, of course, Under Your Spell, who was second in that race and has since come out to win the World Sports Betting Fillies Guineas a week ago. So that form line's looking good. And this filly, when you look at the 2, 4, 5 runs she's had this season, they've been over 1200, 1500, 1800, and 1600 meters. And I'm sure most of you out there will agree that her best trip in her career could be 2000 meters, because at the end of last season, the way she won that gold bracelet, that was superb. The way she just turned on the jets and made it look very, very easy. This is a favorite course. Off her 6 starts at Greyville, she's had 5 wins, and she's unbeaten over the course and distance as well. And although she is carrying 61.5 kgs, you just have to have a look at the best weighted column, and she's well clear in that column. She's a keeper at a 112, and the next best, which is Opera Queen, is at a 103. So it makes 4.5 kgs better off with the next best weighted in the race in this KRA East Coast Cup, a listed race over 2,000 meters. So I'm going to say that this is going to be her first win this season as a 5-year-old. I think she deserves it. She's done the traveling. She's bumped the best of her sex in the country. And this looks like the right type of feel from her. Again, having a word with Garrett Finzel, he goes in quietly confident. He's a guy that, you know, he's quite steady when it comes to not being overly confident. But he did mention to me that no doubt she's the horse to beat you on Saturday, number 8. She's a Keeper. So those are 3 horses on Saturday. And then I've just picked up 1 horse on Sunday. And it'll be quick and fast. It'll be early. If everything goes according to plan on Saturday, you collect early on Sunday, because it comes up in race number 1. and this is over 1,450 meters, and I'm going with the obvious horse. It's long overdue now. Shikoko for an informed stable of Roy Magna and an informed jockey as well. If you missed racing on Thursday, well, the first three races were won by Roy Magna, and two of them were with jockey Gavin Larina. So I'm hoping that good form midweek can continue into the weekend for the stable. And once she moved from KZN to the Highveld, she's had three runs for 3 seconds. And those 3 seconds, well, you could say that she's found one better on the day. She's just looking for something to give, to put her head in front. And I think she's bumped the right field at the right time there. She's knocking hard on the door. And the strike rate that Gavin has with Roy Magna, it's clear to see that he shares a very healthy strike rate with that stable. Whenever he gets on, you have to stand up and take notice. And last start, when second behind Zenobi Princess, well, I can tell you that Zenobian Princess has since come out at Greyville to run second, the two-year-old, in a competitive race behind Miss Missouri, Doug Campbell's runner. So that was a good post-maiden run from the winner of the horse that beat Shikoko last time out, Zenobian Princess. So I think all things being equal on Sunday, Shikoko will be a popular choice for many to anchor in your all-to-comes bets on Sunday. But we're hoping that she is the filly that can close up our treble on Sunday. And both those trebles, as I mentioned, will be up on the World Sports Betting menu. So those horses, we'll recap on those horses after we go to our straight line place accumulator. It's a big day for the sponsor, World Sports Betting. So I've decided, let's go big here. Let's go with a straight line place accumulator, because this card just seems to suit my eye, and we're hoping that everything goes according to plan. Okay, the straight line place accumulator, I'll give you the number and the horse's name. You can jot this down. Race number 3 is when the place accumulator will begin. That's at 12:25, 25 past 12. And in the first leg, we're going with number 4, Totally Rocks. That will be Anton Marcus and Dennis Dryer, hoping to put that last start behind him, behind her. That's the filly. Was a bit disappointing as the odds-on favourite last time out. Then in race number 4, we're going with Floriana Island. That will be Paul Matchett and Muzi Yeni. Bring some solid Gauteng form into the race. And while she's in open company, I think that Gauteng form should be good enough to see her finish in the top 3. And then one of our horses to follow, a banker, race 5, number 5 in the summertime. Race 6, a banker, number 8, she's a keeper. And then in race number 7, which is the main event, the World Sports Betting 1900, a Group 2, and the return of an absolute star who's given us some wonderful memories over the year, a dual Durban July winner as well. And the word is that he is doing superbly well. Of course, this is his favorite province. This is where he comes alive. Each year he comes to the province. He really thrives in the conditions in KZN. And hopefully he can deliver for the guys that are going to be following him on Saturday. Top 3, I think he will certainly do that for the place accumulator. Race number 8, I've gone with number 12, Manhattan Cafe. Did like that last start from Manhattan Cafe. I thought it was a good run against this type of field. All he needs is a bit of luck from the draw, and I think that the change of surface as well will suit him now that he's on the turf. And then race number 9, I'm going with the Mike de Kock train, number 4, El Sahit. I think blinkers on, and he is the horse to beat on his best form. He's always been thought of as a very talented individual, and hopefully he can get the job done there in that Pinnacle Stakes in race number 9. So, to recap on what's happening, well, those two trebles will be up, and it is ready to fly in the summertime, and she's a keeper on Saturday. And then on Sunday, we are going with Shikoko in race number 1 at Turfantine. And then at straight line place accumulator, guys, just to recap the numbers. Straight line, 4 by 3 by 5 by 8 by 6 by 12 and 4. One more time, I'll just go straight line, 4, 3, 5, 8, 6, 12 and 4. And all the best wherever you're racing this weekend, whether it is at Greyville on Saturday, which promises to be a wonderful race meeting. Of course, the main sponsor on the day is the sponsor of Trackside, which is World Sports Betting. And then on Sunday, we move over to Turfentine. Have an awesome weekend. Find all the winners. And hopefully, everything goes according to plan for our selections on Trackside. On behalf of World Sports Betting, thanks to all the punters. But more importantly and more especially, thanks to you, the valued customer. Until next week, you take care. Salarigashle.